Welcome back, troglodytes, to the Trogly's Guitar Show. Today we have a custom shop Donzi Les Paul. Now, as you could tell by that montage I created, Donzi is a powerboat company. So, not just your leisure boats, these are like racing boats, I guess, and I didn't even know that was a thing until getting this guitar. This company was founded in 1964 by a guy named Don Arino, and his nickname was Donzi. He was basically a champion of speedboat racing, and he just decided to make his own company, is the gist of what I understand of it anyways. His first big success was a boat called the Sweet 16, and it was so popular that Lyndon B. Johnson and the Israeli military actually ordered them. So how much is a Donzi boat? From what I looked up, they're around $50,000 to $70,000, so they are definitely a high-end boat. But why on earth does this company even have a signature Les Paul, you're wondering? Well, it's because in the late 90s, early 2000s, Gibson was kind of re-establishing itself as a brand. When the current Juskowitz era started in the late 80s, they kind of went through some experimental times. They finally struck big with the Les Paul Classic series, so they were kind of sailing on smooth waters. So they partnered with tons of different companies to create a bunch of limited edition guitars. Now, I don't have a complete list of all the companies that made signature guitars, but some of the ones I featured on my channel previously are like the Zippo Lighter Guitar, the Yahoo Explorer, the Pepsi Les Paul, the Playboy Bunny Les Pauls, and the Bunny Guitar. And who doesn't want a Fruit of the Loom Underwear Company signature guitar? Now, the specs on these guitars can vary wildly depending on which company you're going for, but I've got to say, this is the first one that actually intrigued me enough to buy it. This guitar is essentially a custom shop reissue guitar. It has a long neck tenon and an ABR1 bridge, and for me, that means this is just as good as any R8 or R9 out there. It features all nickel hardware that has beautifully aged because this guitar has been in Florida its whole life. There's a lot of salt in the air. And you have 57 classic humbuckers in here, along with Grover tuners. And really, the whole design of this guitar, I personally think it just works. This isn't a pure blue finish. It's actually kind of a sparkle blue, but not so overly sparkly that you don't want to take it out. And then you have the Donzi emblem right here, which is a lion and a dolphin. And you kind of have that neck through vibe going on. I think I personally really like this guitar because it kind of reminds me of a Spotlight Special in a way. They have the company name inlaid on the ebony fretboard that says Donzi. And they opted for a blank headstock with a mother of pearl Gibson logo. I think they should have went with the red Z for Donzi on the headstock as well. I think that would have looked even cooler. But it's your standard maple top, mahogany back, and mahogany neck, so this really is just as good as any reissue guitar. Now, I'm going to tell you, this thing plays fantastically. I am very happy with the purchase of these guitars. That's right, you heard me right, I said guitars. I was surfing Reverb one day, and I saw this one, and I was like, that is way too cheap of a price. What's going on with this guitar? The thing had tons of watchers, the photos just weren't very good, and I'm sure a lot of people thought this guitar was a fake. And even I wasn't 100% convinced from the given photos, so I thought, alright, I'll try to make an offer. I ended up making a deal on it. So when I got this guitar, I was so pleasantly surprised that it was historic spec and that it plays and sounds fantastic, I went ahead and bought the guy's other one as well. His listings were so critically undervalued, and yet these things had been sitting in his shop for a few weeks. I just couldn't believe it. Now, personally, I would never do anything to change these guitars, but these are a perfect historic makeover candidate. If you don't know what the historic makeover program is, it's basically like a boutique aging and refinishing shop where they'll take your normal historic spec guitar and they'll refinish it and make it look just like an original burst. Now, people pay good money for that process. The highest end makeover they do costs $4,500, but that would include a complete refinish, and they'll shape the top carve more vintage style. They'll stamp a brand new serial number. They'll give it the vintage neck profile. The neck will be reset with proper hide glue. A Brazilian rosewood fretboard with correct looking inlays will be placed on it. All of the binding will be done in historically correct Royal Light binding. And finally, it'll be professionally set up. Now, for an R8 or R9 to have that process done and then be sold secondhand used, you're looking a little bit more than the cost of this guitar being sent to them and customized to your own specs. So if you've been looking for a great candidate for that, unfortunately, these are perfect for that, but I honestly just say leave them as is. This thing, it just inspires me to play a lot. I don't know, there's something very interesting about it. Not everybody's gonna like this whole design as much as I do, but I never really knew what Donzi was before this. I just know Donzi sounds cool, and you've got a sweet kind of metallic blue guitar, and it's built with 50s traditional specs. Now again, these are custom shop guitars, and this was a limited edition run out of 100. I own number 1 and number 2, which is kind of interesting to say. Number 2 was definitely played a lot, and number 1's more of a collector's piece. Now, were these guitars ever for sale somewhere? Believe it or not, yes, these were sold by custom shop dealers. However, they also use these as promotional tools at like boat shows and things like that. Some companies also gave their signature guitars away to their executives. So yes, I highly recommend this guitar. If you're just looking for something different or just an excellent playing guitar, I definitely suggest going for this one. Now that we know a little bit more about this guitar, let's go ahead and hear how the Donzi sounds.
We'll be right back.
Now that we know how this speedboat sounds, let's go ahead and review its condition. Alright, so this guitar was definitely played. You can see you've got some light string change wear on the face of the headstock, but for the most part, you're in clean shape. This was the hardest truss rod cover to ever get off. It was like still glued to it. So I had to take a screwdriver and I used a protective cloth to kind of chisel it off. The truss rod's definitely been used before, but it's not maxed out or anything. And you do still have your original nut. The frets show very minor wear, hardly any at all. And again, this is an ebony fretboard inlaid with the brand's name, Donzi. Now this guitar plays pretty smoothly. I will say that the tuners, in my experience, kind of slip a lot. I found myself having to continuously retune this guitar. Now, that could just be because I was bending on this guitar like crazy a lot, or maybe it needs some fresher strings on it. Now, there are quite a few polish scratches and nicks and dings on the front of this guitar. You can see right there where there's some wear, especially in the armrest area. I tried polishing that off. I wasn't really successful. But then again, I also dirtied this guitar up after I played it. The worst cosmetic blemish on the front is right here. It's like this hit against something and chipped the finish a little bit. And honestly, since this is there, I find I'm not scared to really hammer on this guitar. It's a limited edition guitar, but it's not necessarily worth, you know, 10 grand or anything crazy. Now this one has a stock white pick guard. My number one does not have a pick guard installed. And again, you have 57 classic humbuckers with aged nickel hardware. Back of the headstock, our serial number is CS21724, limited edition number 2 out of 100. And again, this was built in the Gibson Custom Shop. We've got some very light edge wear on this guitar, but nothing too major. I would say the neck profile is closer to a 60s, but it's not like a super slim, but not quite to the medium territory. This neck was very comfortable for me to play though. You just kind of have some light nicks and dings here or there on the playing surface. Now the back of the guitar, the certificate of authenticity kind of scratched it up while it was sitting in its case, and you also have some other buckle worming marks as well. But that kind of adds to the you're not scared to play this guitar vibe. You can see there's kind of a larger impression mark right there. Now the only thing that's not 50 spec'd is you do have the thick binding in the cutaway, but you could easily correct that if you wanted to during the historic makeover. But the sides of the guitar, you've got some dirt buildup, some scratches, nicks and dings. But overall, it's just such an excellent guitar. Now we'll take a look under blacklight. You can see everything glows on the front the way I would expect to see. Again, the largest area of wear is right here where the finish chipped. Sides of the guitar are also looking good. You can see you might have a little bit of stand rash here that you can only see under blacklight. But everything else is looking fine. Back of the guitar is also looking the way I would expect to see, as is the back of the neck and the headstock. The only thing that's a little weird here is you've got some weird blacklight areas right here. Not sure what would cause that. It could be like a clip-on tuner was left for a long time. You can see that on the front of the headstock as well. So I think a capo is our best bet with that one. As you can see here, a normal lighting situation, that's not even apparent on the front. But now that I know it's there, you can kind of see the discoloration on the back. This guitar still has its custom art historic Gibson case. These cases themselves sell for a pretty good amount, around $250 to $300. And everything's functioning on this one. You can see you've got some storage wear and tear, scratches, but everything functions as it should. Now I do want to note, this lid sticks to the bottom of this case. So if you haven't opened it in a while, you've kind of got to hold the handle down and then press up really hard to get it to come undone. But inside the case is a beautiful burgundy material. And these really are fantastic cases. They're nice and plush and they're beautiful as well. This guitar also retains its original certificate of authenticity, thankfully, since it is the large paper one. If you think you might be interested in being the next owner of the Donzi Les Paul, feel free to contact me on my Facebook page, facebook.com/troglys, T-R-O-G-L-Y-S. Thank you, Troggle Dice, for tuning in. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe, and we will see you tomorrow on the next episode. Take care.